this afternoon, we are at the Agency for Health Quality and Assessment of Catalonia, AQUAS, the headquarters of the health department in Barcelona. We'll be explaining the evaluation work packages of this European Act on Dementia project. My name is Vicky Serra Sutton. I'm a sociologist and expert in health services research. Have you ever considered what a joint action is for and if its products are robust and credible? We were familiar with the concept of evaluation and its applicability in the field of health services research and quality assessment. So what we've done in this joint action along the project has been to deepen in the concept of evaluation and its applicability in the fields of decision making and also dementia. Today, we would like to explain you the three main points. First of all, the approach of evaluation. Second, the challenges and opportunities. And third, some lessons learned from these collaborations. AQUAS is a public institution linked to the health department and also the Catalan government. The mission of AQUAS is to generate knowledge for decision making in different key areas. The key topics are the assessment of healthcare system, research in healthcare quality, data analysis through big data, development of evidence tools for decision making, and then AQUAS also adds value in the field of innovation and participative strategies. We would like also to introduce other members of the team. Mireia Espallarga, she's a medical doctor, specialist in public health. She's the director of assessment and quality area at AQUAS. And also Gemma Cabré, she's a business manager and our financial and economical officer at AQUAS.
I'm Maria Dolors Estrada. I'm a medical doctor, a specialist in public health. Today, we would like to share with you the approach we have used to evaluate the methodological quality of key products and how we have evaluated impact. To understand the evaluation of the methodological quality of Act on Dementia products, it is important to explain that the project is divided into phases. In the evidence phase, best practices were identified together with their benefits. In a second implementation phase, best practices were selected and tested in different pilot sites across Europe. These structures apply to the core areas for this joint action: diagnosis and post-diagnosis support, crisis and coordination, quality of residential care, and dementia-friendly communities. To evaluate the impact of the joint action, there was a first phase dedicated to define what impact was and especially adapted to Act on Dementia joint action. It was agreed that impact of the joint action would be conceptualized as benefits, global achievements, and expected changes as a consequence of Act on Dementia. In a second phase, a conceptual framework for impact assessment of Act on Dementia was defined. This framework helped World Package 3 to propose a list of measures to assess the impact of Act on Dementia in the future. In a third and last phase, a qualitative study with interviews to key informants was carried out to collect their opinion on their benefits and perceived changes as a consequence of this joint action.
The challenges and opportunities of the evaluation process within Act on Dementia have been learning, sharing, agreeing, and defining a tool for the assessment of methodological quality of Act on Dementia. We've been able to adapt this kind of tools and their criteria to potentiate and ensure that this process for the identification of best practices in the field of dementia were robust and also their selection based on the evidence. In Act on Dementia, we've learned more about these tools and we have had the opportunity to collaborate with Trimbos Institute and take it into consideration the criteria applied within the European Commission in the portal of best practices. We consider this learning process and this practical application we've done has allowed to evaluate in a homogeneous way and establish what the methodological quality is through a score and also a threshold. We have been able to apply the health consensus tool. It has allowed generating collective intelligence around key topics and essential topics in the field of dementia, such as the improvement of tools for a correct diagnosis of dementia and other instruments to assess the needs of people living with dementia and their caregivers. And finally, the qualitative study has allowed to collect the voices of people directly, more or less involved in the joint action from different disciplines about their perception of the benefits, learnings and achievements of this joint action.
The evaluation of the impact of a joint action is possible within the project, mainly to reach an agreement on the expected potential impact benefits to be measured in the future. This impact should be promoted from the beginning of the project. To conclude, the evaluation of ACT on Dementia has allowed promoting a methodological quality culture and also move forward in ways to measure their impact.
My name is Pierre Crolac-Salmon. I'm a neurologist and geriatrician in Lyon. I'm the head of the Lyon Institute for Elderly and the Lyon Memory Center at the University Hospital. Our work package dealt with diagnosis and post-diagnosis support. The GPs in Europe do not detect the neurocognitive disorder. We wanted to help them and provide different action to enhance the diagnosis rates in primary care. The GPs do not really understand the benefits and the risk related to the diagnosis. So we worked on ethical issues regarding the benefits and the risk of the diagnosis. So we disclosed that the benefits are much higher than risk of the diagnosis. The main benefits are related to the right to know, the information regarding the cognitive modifications and behavioral modifications, the access to the care process, the care pathways, and the risks are related to stigma. And we all agreed that we should propose a graduated, hierarchized diagnosis strategy and a strategy that is tailored to the patient. Then we began the implementation programs in different countries. The first kind of program was related to a new kind of GP trainings to face the ethics issues related to the diagnosis and detection in primary care. We tested another implementation program that was related to a GP-nurse collaboration to try to help the GPs to detect the neurocognitive disorders. We could show that a GP-nurse collaboration is very efficient. We think also it was really comfortable for the patient because the testing could be done at the GP office, but also at home.
Bonjour, je suis Nathalie Dumoitier, je suis médecin généraliste installée donc à Limoges, dans le centre de la France. Pourquoi j'ai participé à ce travail? Alors d'une part parce que je pense en tant que médecin généraliste, moi en tout cas, je suis confrontée quasiment tous les jours à des patients pour lesquels donc on peut envisager que derrière il y a un problème. Nos patients, ils viennent nous voir, bien souvent, ils viennent pour autre chose, parce qu'ils ont mal au ventre, parce qu'ils viennent renouveler leur traitement de l'hypertension, du diabète. Et puis, on a la chance, nous, de les connaître, ces patients, depuis des années. Puis parfois, un jour, on voit qu'il y a quelque chose qui a changé. Ils ont oublié le rendez-vous, ou ils ont du mal à faire le chèque pour payer à la fin de la consultation. Et là, pour nous, c'est le moment de se dire, peut-être qu'il se passe quelque chose. Le patient ne se plaint de rien, donc lui. Et je pense qu'en tant que médecin généraliste, c'est la chance qu'on a de les connaître, ces patients, depuis longtemps, et d'identifier qu'il y a peut-être un problème donc, qui débute avant même que les patients, eux, ne s'en plaignent et n'évoquent des symptômes. Donc ça, je crois que la place du généraliste dans une mise en place d'une procédure précoce, en tout cas donc, de prise en charge pour ces patients, pour moi, c'est impératif. Et c'est quasiment tous les jours.
My name is Dr. Leslie Cartes-Pivert. I am a neurologist and geriatrician. I work in the memory clinic, University Memory Clinic in Limoges. In our area, the central part of France, we have a very older population. Almost 25% of our population is aged over 65. It was very interesting to return to the GPs a year later and have their opinion about what the training and if it had any change on their practice. We have very good results. For example, in the diagnostic process of neurocognitive disorders, 77% of the GPs answered that they approached this differently. They started the diagnostic process early on the disease, and that they worked better with the memory clinics and other specialists. They used more tests. So these are very concrete results. When it comes to diagnosis disclosure, 54% of the GPs said that they would emphasize now on less dramatic aspects of dementia, on what would continue, on all the help that can be put together, so that this diagnosis disclosure is not as alarming to the patients, and that they would also pay special care to what they would say to the patient and to the family in terms of words, the words chosen, the expressions that they used. When it comes to support and anticipation, 70% of the GPs said that now they were more comfortable offering support, helping caregivers, anticipating stopping to drive, legal protection, all sorts of very practical situations that are very important when it comes to quality of life. From this joint action, there will be recommendations, and this recommendation should be very useful for all the countries to develop their own programs and help GPs act on dementia.
Ik ben Lisette en ik ben ketenregisseur van het ketenprogramma Hulp bij Dementie in de regio Noord-Limburg. En door mee te werken aan dit project, ja, zijn die antennes die staan weer op scherp, zeg maar. En zijn we dus gaan kijken van wat zouden wij nu nog beter, anders kunnen veranderen. Omdat we dus zien dat mensen steeds langer thuis blijven wonen. Die vragen komen steeds vaker bij ons. En hoe zouden wij daar nou beter mee om kunnen gaan? En wij, dat is dan weer al die mensen die hier samenwerken uit al die verschillende organisaties met allemaal hun eigen expertise, hoe krijgen we dat bij elkaar gebracht?
Ik ben Petra Zwager, ik ben ook specialist ouderengeneeskunde en kaderarts psychogeriatrie. Ik werk voor het Vincent van Gogh, dat is de GGZ-instelling hier in Noord-Limburg. En ik kom eigenlijk vooral bij de mensen thuis ik werk ook binnen Hulp bij Dementie. Ook daaruit kom ik bij de mensen thuis voor bijvoorbeeld diagnostiek naar dementie, onder andere. DECTEAM is eigenlijk, het staat voor Diagnostisch Expertisecentrum. Het is een samenwerkingsverband waarbij verschillende disciplines van organisaties wekelijks bij elkaar komen. Dus de trajectbegeleiders, een specialist oudergeneeskunde van de zorggroep in dit geval, specialist oudergeneeskunde van de GGZ, ook een deel de psychiater van de GGZ en een psycholoog. En in dat DECTEAM worden eigenlijk nieuwe aanmeldingen besproken. Dus mensen waarbij er een vraag is voor trajectbegeleiding, dan wel eventueel ook diagnostiek naar dementie.
Ik ben Inge Beurske, specialist ouderengeneeskunde, werk bij de zorggroep. En ik doe het grootste deel van mijn werk intramuraal en een deel extramuraal, onder andere voor hulp bij dementie.
Dat klopt. En ook met rondom de geriaters ook wel, ja, wie doet wat op welk moment, als wij er eventueel niet meer uit kunnen, dat je doorverwijst of zij hebben iemand gezien, komen er niet uit, kunnen zij ook naar ons of de trajectbegeleiders verwijzen om toch diagnostiek wat verder in kaart te krijgen of meer informatie te verzamelen om diagnostiek wel beter rond te krijgen.
Ik ben Matthijs van Oorloos, ik ben trajectbegeleider bij Hulp bij Dementie. En ik doe dit werk nu 6 jaar ongeveer en ik ben gekoppeld aan alle huisartsenpraktijken van de gemeente Horst. Mensen blijven steeds langer thuis wonen en komen daardoor ook steeds verder in hun dementie, gaan achteruit en komt er dan ook vaak onbegrepen gedrag naar voren. En als trajectbegeleider probeer ik dan in de thuissituatie een analyse te maken van wat er precies aan de hand is. en wat we daar eventueel mee kunnen. Ik heb een paar jaar geleden zelf bij Trimbos de training gevolgd over onbegrepen gedrag. Wij proberen tijdens de huisbezoeken al op, wij steken ook het liefst zo vroeg mogelijk in, zodat we dan juist ook kinderen en partners uit kunnen leggen wat ze wel moeten doen, wat ze beter niet kunnen doen, zodat ze in dat traject als mantelzorger ook groeien. Onder andere ook deze flyer opgesteld met een aantal collega's. En de reden dat we dat eigenlijk hebben gedaan is dat wij het gevoel hebben dat huisartsen, wijkverpleegkundigen, WMO-afdelingen niet allemaal duidelijk voor ogen hebben wat het DEC is en wat wij kunnen betekenen voor de mensen thuis. Dus deze flyer hebben we opgesteld en daar staat dat eigenlijk in uitgelegd wie we zijn, wat we doen en wat we voor de mensen kunnen betekenen. En deze hebben we ook digitaal, dus ik heb die bijvoorbeeld naar al mijn professionele contacten gestuurd van bekijk deze informatie, zodat we hopen dat het...
Nou, wat misschien ook nog belangrijk is, is wat we heel graag willen, is dat als er dus er zijn adviezen gegeven, er is een plan gemaakt voor een cliënt en die gaat verhuizen intramuraal, dat zo'n plan, zeg maar die adviezen, dat meegaat naar een intramurale setting en dat ze daar weer niet opnieuw het wiel gaan uitvinden van hoe moeten we omgaan met het gedrag van deze mevrouw of deze meneer. Dat is ook een, ja, waar we nu wel mee bezig zijn, met name ook door dit project. Zo van hoe gaan we ervoor zorgen dat de overgang van extra naar intramuraal, als het gaat over gedrag en hoe gaan we daarmee om, dat ja, wij zeggen dat dan soepeler, zachter, vriendelijker voor de cliënt gaat verlopen en dat niet daar weer opnieuw een onderzoek moet gaan plaatsvinden.
I'm Kostis Prouskas. I'm a psychologist with a PhD in gerontology. I'm the chairman and CEO of Actios Elderly Care Unit. We strongly believe that nurses are the main pillar in our service provision. In Actios, we operate with a dynamic model of operation. We usually have people living with us who suffer from dementia or other kinds of neurodegenerative diseases. A part of this program was to teach our nurses to better recognize the behavioral and the psychiatric symptoms of dementia. We tried to do that because we wanted to establish a new way of communication between our nurses and our doctors, psychiatrists or neurologists. We wanted also to see whether the antipsychotic medication was adequate or if it was necessary. We managed to teach some of our nurses, whom we used later on as mentors to the rest of our personnel, how to identify the psychiatric and behavioral disorders and symptoms, how to describe them to the physicians, how to set new goals and therapeutic plans, and how to maintain new ways of communicating with the residents and their families. We always notice that it is very helpful for the families and the employees to understand the nature of dementia and see what really constitutes the psychiatric and behavioral aspect of it. So they learn to differentiate between the disease and the personality.
My name is Adamos Konstantinou. I'm a psychiatrist. I am the scientific supervisor in Hippocratio Therapeutirio. That is a private psychiatric clinic. The main purpose of the program was to train nurses. Our patients are mostly demented patients, moderate to severe illness with many severe comorbidities. The final result for our clinic was the improvement in the satisfaction of our patients, the satisfaction of the nurses, and the satisfaction of the relatives of the patients.
I'm Borbolakos Theofanis. I'm an assistant professor in psychiatry in Demokritos University of Thras. The residential house is called Stavridio Foundation, and it's run by the church. The culture of the nurses and the administration there gradually changed, and they became much more involved. after that, the culture changed, and although the aim to control the behavior still remains, which is essential for their function, side effects and the downside of over-prescribing and antipsychotic prescribing, it's much more obvious. The relatives were very satisfied with the improvement of patients' mobility and the interaction that patients, most of them, had with their relatives.
My name is Antonis Politis. I am professor of psychiatry in the Department of Psychiatry of Athens Medical School. And I'm leading also the Act of Dementia, the Greek actions. The goal of the Greek joint action is to implement projects in areas that nobody till now worked in order to raise the awareness for dementia patients. We built up a program focused mostly in educate them to diagnosis and to behavioral disturbance, to recognize and to manage behavioral disturbance and first of all the diagnosis of dementia. And in this perspective we use the telemedicine from the university, and it was a very, very surprising good news that the telemedicine worked very well in order to train the trainer. Training the personnel through distance is very important because we save cost. We save money, and it's very important that we can link universities that is very far from rural areas with long-term care units that are in the rural areas. They realize they can use different scales in order to understand behavioral disturbances. They use different scales in order to evaluate their cognitive status. And at the end, their patients, they are very happy to create a relationship through this process. We are thinking in the future to create a platform with the Ministry of Digital Policy in order any persons of the long-term care units, any nurse of the long-term care units to be able to go through the platform in a very specific educational program.
Bulgaria participated in Act on Dementia by sharing work from a pilot site for dementia-friendly communities. The example of best practice they share with the joint action are meetings of support groups for people with dementia and their caregivers. They meet twice per month in the municipality of Sofia at the Memory Centre of the University Hospital Alexandrovska. On the 1st of October, a film screening was held here as part of Bulgaria's Let's Live Together campaign. The film Syndrome was watched by people with dementia and their families.
My name is Paola Cucchetti. I'm an English teacher here at Istituto Bachelet in Abbiategrasso, a small town 20 kilometers far from Milan. I'm very proud about this project, and I've decided to participate in this project because I know that I'm doing something which is very, very important for my town, but also for the whole community, not only of Abbiategrasso, but in general. That I will go on representing the link between Fondazione and our school, and being a testimonial also with our students, with my students. And for this reason, even today, later on, we are organizing a fantastic event, which is the presentation to our town, to Abbiategrasso, of a new space which is called the Spazio Alzheimer inside our library, which will be a place where people affected by dementia or any form of this illness, their parents, their relatives, their caregivers, can go and find our students who are always willing to help and can be there just with a word, smiling and so on. The fact that the students with their work have brought something very important to my community is very important also for me, and it makes me very, very, very proud.
I'm Palmira Aurora and I'm 16. I am a student from Bachelet High School. What makes me proud to be a part of this project is the fact that I always wanted to help others, and with this project I know that I'm doing something good and I'm helping all these people affected by dementia to live a normal life like everyone else. And with small action we are changing the view of our society. Even my parents are really proud of that, of this, because they know that I'm doing something great, and this makes me feel good because I know that I'm a good person. And maybe in the future, someone else will do this for me.
My name is Iris. I'm 16 years old, and I'm a student here in the Institut Bachelet. We students, we thought that the best idea to spread the message was to create a flash mob. So we talked to our teachers, and they talked to the foundation, and we decided together as a group to plan to organize this event. We set off the flash mob in 5 different crucial places in our city, Abbiategrasso. And we decided to do that on Saturday morning, yes, because it's the best day of the week. In fact, the city is quite busy and it's crowded, so we already know that there would have been a lot of people there. So it was a good way to let all the people know what we do, what the foundation does, because not all the people are very informed here in Abbiategrasso, so it's a good idea, yes.
Okay, hi, I'm Greta, I live in Abbiategrasso, I'm 17 years old and I go to Bachelet High School. I'd like to talk about my experience that I made with my classmates at the market, because one day we went to the market in our city center and we submitted some questionnaires to old people because we wanted to understand if people have problems during their way to from their house to the market. And it was, I think it was a success. I also think that it was a nice experience also because I'm so shy, and this helped me to feel a little bit more confident with people.
I'm Adam Benassi, I'm 17, from Bachelet High School. We thought about creating a page on Instagram, so spread the sensibility about person affected by dementia. We think that this Instagram page can attract young people.
Hi, I'm Gioia. I'm a student of Bachelet, a school of Abbiategrasso. And now we are at the library. There is a conference about Dementia Friendly Community that is a project started here. We are trying to invite people of all the ages in this project for know the problem of dementia.